countdown across Australia. And here is your host and special guest for tonight, Johnny Cougar.
Hello. Yeah. Sure. We interrupt this program to bring you a special announcement. Johnny Cougar will not be hosting the show because he's living in Miami.
Johnny Cougar's enjoying living in Miami, but we're sure glad Russell Morris came back to Australia, because here he is live with his band doing Hot Love.
But I ain't gonna let you get too far out of my sight at all today, babe. So if you've got a mind to go wandering out now, you better save it for a rainy day. Some people might object and tell you now that I've got too strong. But the more I see you now, the more I want you. What they think, I don't give a damn. Someone called me, I wouldn't turn around. The ground started shaking, I wouldn't feel it now, cause I'm the dream late last night was all about the rain. It gave me some mighty peculiar insights into the way I feel about you, baby. You're all wet and naked as you were standing there. You were so desperate for someone's helping hand, so shake and I didn't hear a sound, cause I was high on you, hot love. I was high on you, hot love. I was high on you, hot love again. We were tumbling down, straight through the clouds, so lost in the dream that I was heaven seas. You were running wild through the streets in the night. I was chasing you in vain, through all of the rain. Cause we were running, tumbling, and all of the time. Shaking, I didn't hear a sound, cause I was
going state hopping for our Chartbusters this week, and we may as well start off in Melbourne. Roger Vadouris jumped from 24 to 15 with Get Used to It. Next, we're over the border and in the middle of Brazil. In Adelaide, the Tubes are getting prime time. Ad have chart busted from 36 to 28 to 19.
Countdown, my friends. This is a serious part. Now, I'd like to introduce you to Joe Camilleri from Jojo Zep, who will be doing their new record later on today. And
yay!
We've also got UK Freeze. And we've got...
Also, with a great group. Great group.
Oh, yeah, they're good. Good group.
Cool.
Are they from UK? Or are they
are. They're the English version. Of course, we've got Amy Stewart's got a new record out, and Chris Rea, who was on Countdown a couple
and
of
right
weeks ago.
Right now, we've got ELO with Shine.
Mm.
Seven Fabulous with a great new song, Hit and Run. After quite a drought, we're finally getting some good English music. 79 began with Ian Dury, then moved on to Racy, Lena Lovitch and M. The UK squeeze are no exception. Here they are with Cool for Cats.
And he wakes to find the fire's dead and arrows in his hat. And Davy Crockett rides around and says it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats. The Sweeney's doing 90 because they've got nowhere to go. They get a gang of villains in a shed up at Heathrow. They're counting out the fivers when the handcuffs lock again. In and out of ones with the numbers on their names. It's funny how the missus always looks a bleeding sane. And meanwhile at the station there's a couple of likely lads who swear like as your father and they're very cool for cats, they're cool for cats. The mood a little, I've been posing down the pub. I'm seeing my reflection, I'm looking slightly rough. I fancy this, I fancy that, I wanna be so flash. I give a little muscle and I spend a little cash. But all I get is bitter and a nasty little rash. And by the time I'm sober, I've forgotten what I've had. And everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat, cool for cats. Questions as she hangs onto the wall. I kiss her for the first time and then I take her home. I'm invited in for coffee and I give the dog a bone. She likes to go to discos but she's never on her own. I said I'll see you later and I'll give her some old chat. But it's not like they on the TV. When it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats.
Looks like we've got Chris Rea, who was here a couple of weeks ago on Countdown with that $1 million smile and the the blue-eyed demon that he was. What a fantastic dresser.
A bit, mate,
I am a bit, you know, a bit past it, you know.
He was a clean-looking boy, wasn't
yeah,
he?
He was, wasn't he? He's got spunk, I think they call it.
That's what they call it. He's getting a lot of airplay, too. That
yeah, voice. Well, he's got a great tune called Diamonds.
There are girls with spunk. Right?
She did it to Eddie Floyd's Knock on Wood, and now it's the Doors' turn for the Amy Stewart treatment. Here she is with Light My Fire.
Come on, baby, light my fire.
His album was at number 16 nationally this week. Here's their second song from that album, Let's Get Back Together.
This time with
Joey
from the Russell Morris Band.
Yeah, how you doing? Yeah, this is a band that's just
this one here. Oh, yeah, that one, right? Yeah.
This is a band that's just finished touring with Talking Heads. Where are they from?
They're from New Zealand.
Yeah,
they're
right.
Good band.
Yeah, they're great. They're called My Sex, and the single off the album coming in out in 3 weeks is called But You Don't Care.
But we do.
We do, yeah.
Blah! lightning flash in the plate glass. The reflection spurs a hole in the back of my eyes. While an old man saunters nearby, not noticing the flash of the four walls inside. I got you down on your bended knees. You're back for more treatment, please. Why can't you let it be a tree stump twist? Your love shall not be missed. But you don't care. You just don't care. Well, if there ain't no feelings there, I bet you don't care.
Is a new craze that has brought smiles to the faces of orthopedic surgeons throughout the world. Supercharge Roller Disco to I Can See You Right Now. Roundtree as they get on up, get on down.
What if you feel like party and? Why don't you get on up, up, up?
one time, racy with some girls.
Need a lot of loving in a some girl's home. Well, I know I've got the fever, but I don't know why. Some say they will let some girls lie. So here I am in front of you, not really knowing what to do. My heart is feeling something new. Nervously I turn away from you. Those looks you're sending me, is this the way it's meant to be? It's something we should talk about. Just give me time to work it out.
Some girls will, some girls won't. Some girls need a lot of loving in them, some girls don't. I know I've got the fever, but I don't know why. Some say they will and some girls.
Something completely new to me. Now that I know you socially, obviously I'll fall heavily. I've seen those looks you're sending me. This is the way it's meant to be. There's nothing left to talk about, or how I wish you'd work it out.
Some girls will, some girls won't. Some girls need a lot of loving in them, some girls don't.
I turn away from you.
Some girls will, some girls won't. Some girls need a lot of loving in them, some girls don't.
Okay, now you've got to tune into your sets next week, into Channel 2, incidentally, a lot earlier, because at 4:25, it's a show called Sunday Spectrum, and they're going to do all the behind scenes of Countdown. You won't believe it. I mean, you'll see us all arguing and scratching things out and sort of trying to work out the show. It's a great little special. It's half an hour, and it'll appear on Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane and Hobart television at 4:25. In Adelaide, it'll be at 3:25 p.m. And Perth, I'm sorry, you're going to have to wait a week, because it's not on until the week after, and that's at 4:25. So tune into your sets early next Sunday on ABC television. All right, it's a really good special. One group that you won't have heard of is a group called Night, and I think this album is unreal. Richard Perry, who just recently produced the Pointer Sisters, produced this album, and if I turn it around like that, up there is a guy called Billy Christian, who used to play with Max Merritt in the Meteors out in Australia. This guy here is one of the guys I admire so much, Nicky Hopkins. He's on keyboards, and he used to play with the Rolling Stones, jam with the Beatles, etc., etc. It's a beautiful album, and I have a feeling that this album could sort of, and this group, Night, could sort of replace Fleetwood Mac to some extent. Watch out for it, Night. All right. One guy that had an enormous hit last year was Jerry Rafferty with Baker Street. He hasn't done much in the charts since then, on the singles charts especially, but I think he's going to do it with this one. Jerry Rafferty with Night Out, his new single.
I should know better, but I can't say no.
right. A group we previewed last week and we showed in full this week was UK Squeeze with Cool for Cats. And I would say they're probably one of the most adventurous groups and one of the most refreshing groups to come out of the UK for quite some time. UK Squeeze, they've done a lot of business over in the UK. Took them by storm, in fact, a couple of weeks ago. And of course, Cool for Cats is roaring up the charts here. Watch out for this group and watch out for this album. This album has got some of the weirdest titles on it. Touching Me, Touching You, It's Not Cricket, Up the Junction, Hard to Find. But I tell you what, it's not hard to find this album because it's in every store and it's one really worth listening to. All right, UK Squeeze, Cool for Cats. One group in Sydney, a young group in Sydney, that I think are really worth having a listen to, and I hope all radio stations give them a very fair go. They're an excellent group. They're called Topaz. They've got a single out now, and it's called Can't Break the Habit. Topaz.
I don't understand. It's never happened before. On these old feet, they want to walk to your door. I can't break the habit. I can't break the habit. Ah, stop it. I guess the pull is just too strong. I can't break the habit. I can't break the habit. Ah, stop it. I guess I'll love you forever.
I'll tell you what, after watching Topaz, it's really good to see that we've got so many varied groups in this country at the moment. There's so much young talent, it's great to see. Incidentally, Jojo Zepp's single, which we previewed, was previewed. It's not out for 10 days. That's the jacket there, called Hit and Run. So don't go out for 10 days to ask for Jojo Zepp's single because it was a very sneak preview. All right, one album that we've been waiting a long time for is Carly Simon. It's titled Spy, and she's coming back with Vengeance because this one is really going to take off in the charts. And incidentally, the single itself is titled Vengeance, and I'm sure it sort of means a lot to Carly, and I'm sure that this thing is going to really race up the charts. And I think her husband, James Taylor, will be sort of rather pleased to see that that it does that, because they haven't really done much over the past 2 years. Carly Simon, back on the charts with Spy. Watch out for it. One bit of hot gossip that no one can confirm, but I'll tell you what, it's near on the cards, is that Fleetwood Mac are definitely touring here in November, and there is a great possibility now that the Rolling Stones could also tour in November, and wait for it, they could also appear on the same bill. So imagine that concert. But let's go back and have a look at the Rolling Stones and Fleetwood Mac. Out in November. Ooh.
Oh, get out of my life. Don't come back.
So there you go. November is going to be a very exciting time. Unfortunately, the Dire Straits tour looks as if it's going to be cancelled for September because of commitments they've got overseas. But wait for it. Also in November, perhaps December, I have a great feeling that Elton John and Ray Cooper are going to tour this country as well. So it should be a really hot rock and roll month, November and December. Another album, which, what can you really say about this group that hasn't been said? They are a superb group. This is their album called I Am Earth, Wind and Fire. It's a really superb album. All those people that have followed Earth, Wind and Fire over the past couple of years are really going to get off on this album. Boogie Wonderland, the single that is really racing up the charts, we previewed it last week, is on this album. And that, if you saw that last week, well, then you know what this album's going to be. It's a really hot album, Earth, Wind and Fire. All right, one guy that I deeply admire, he's a producer, he's a performer, he's a guitarist, his name is Nick Lowe. He's been responsible over the past 2 years of, producing Elvis Costello. He once produced Graham Parker, and he brought all that scene back together in the UK. Here is Nick Lowe by himself as a solo artist with Cracking Up, Mr. Nick Lowe.
Nighttime, a crack of dawn, it comes upon me without warning. If I were gone, then I would shoot. I'd tear the head out by the root. I'd make a knife out of a notion. All at sea in an ocean of emotion. I don't think it's funny no more. I don't think it's funny no more.
Cracking up. Nick Lowe, he might be cracking up, but I tell you what, he's some genius. Mr. Nick Lowe, watch out for him as well. One guy that is our very special guest today is Mr. Robert Palmer. Now, you may not know much about this this particular artist, but he's quite a superb artist, quite a superb performer. He's had many albums out, and they've sort of been hidden away, perhaps a little bit underground, as far as record buying is concerned. I can't understand that, because there's been some really superb songs coming from his albums. This is his new one, Mr. and it's just titled Robert Palmer. And there is an absolute superb version of Todd Rundgren's song that he had a hit with last year, Can We Still Be Friends? But meanwhile, we're going to feature Mr. Robert Palmer, another track off the album, the single, Bad Case of Loving You. Mr. Robert Palmer.
I'm Paul Turner. There's a brand new number one on the national top 10 countdown this week, but first of all, let's start at the top. At number 10, Promises are still hanging in there with Baby It's You. Also moving out slowly but surely is Blondie. This week, Heart of Glass is down from 7 to 9. Perth has finally discovered Lynn Hamilton. Too bad it's too late. On the Inside is also moving out this week. It's number 8. Donna Summer is still number one in America and looks like doing the same thing here. This week, Hot Stuff moved up from 10 to 7. The M stands for Modern Man, but it could also mean mystery. Even his record company can't find him. This week, pop music scorched into the top 10 at number 6. I Will Survive has been surviving in the top 10 for 9 weeks. However, this week, Gloria Gaynor moved down from 4 to 5. There are only 4 songs moving up the top 10 this week, and one of them is Goodnight Tonight, climbed from 5 to 4. Racy have been in the top 10 for 11 weeks. Perhaps the reason is they don't have an album to divide their sales. Anyway, Lay Your Love on Me is number 3 for the second week in a row. After 4 weeks at number one, Amy Stewart's Knock on Wood is now on its way down the charts. And now, it's back to you, Molly.
Okay, thanks, Paul. Robert, welcome to the show. Thanks for doing performing on the show. You're sort of like an elusive performer to me. I mean, like, you've had a lot of albums, and yet you sort of haven't sort of, to me, concentrated on any single market. Is there any reason?
No, well, I enjoy so many different types of music, and yeah. The fashions are always changing. And I like to sing, and I think if I align myself with just one fashion or anything like that, it's sort of short-changing myself, because I like to sing as lot of songs as possible to make a variety and a dynamic when I put on a show.
Now, you're also a songwriter, but yet you sometimes seem to prefer to do other people's songs.
Well, I can only write so many things, and they have a certain style which is my own, and in order again to make it broader, you know, if I hear somebody else's song that appeals to me, I'll stick it in.
Now, I think always one of the hardest things for any performer, especially when someone has had a hit with a song like Can We Still Be Friends, which was Todd Rundgren's, which he wrote, produced and played all the instruments on, I always think it's very hard for any other performer to do a cover version that's acceptable, and yet yours is quite a superb version. Did he ask you, or did you, do you know Todd Rundgren?
No, I'd never heard of him before. I saw him on the TV singing there at home, and it reminded me of those old Tamla Motown ballads, So I just rearranged it and put it in the act, and it went down good, so we recorded it. I think Australia is the only place it was a hit single.
Right. Well, listen, as I say, have a good trip in Australia. You're here until the end of the month.
Yeah.
And when are we going to see you tour?
Hopefully March, April next year, if everything goes well.
Fantastic. All right, listen, it's time to close, to go off with the number one record. And do you like this lady, Lena Luge?
I can't remember having heard her. I've seen lots of pictures of her, though.
Well, it's finally hit number one. We have a new number one. It is, in fact, Lena Luge with a beautiful number. I love dancing to this. It's called Lucky Number. Good night, Robert.
Thank you.
Good night, Australia.
Help yourself.